In this video, we are going to evaluate this integral, then how to solve it. Because inside the integral, there's a product. So we're going to simplify this part first, then the second part. So then do the integral. So now let's work on the first part. So this is the first part. So let's simplify it. Because they have a common factor x, so let's take out x. And here we have 1 minus, so here, x squared. So we put x 2 times 1. The bottom divided by 2, we put a 2 to the power 1. Okay, the second one. X to the fourth, we put x to the power 2 times 2. Then take out a factor 2 from each. So then we have 2 squared. Then we still have 1 times 2. So that's 2 factorial. Then next, so x to the 6th. So we put x to the power 2 times 3. Then take out a factor 2 from each. So then we have 2 to the 3rd. Then still 1 times 2 times 3. So that's 3 factorial. So then here we're going to put 1 factorial. Okay, so then keep going. So next, we try to figure out what's the general term. So then we try to combine these two together, including the negative sign and put on top. Same here. So then same here, combine them, including the negative sign, put on top. Okay, so then here we have, then here we have 1 plus, on the bottom, that's 1 factorial. On top, that's a negative x squared over 2, then to the power 1. Let's see the second one. The bottom, 2 factorial. Then on top, that's a negative x squared over 2, then power 2. Then the third one, the bottom, that's a 3 factorial. So on top, that's negative x squared over 2, then to the power 3. Then keep going. So now we can put them into a summing notation. So here, just sum n from 0 to infinity. So now let's see here. The bottom, just n factorial. On top, it's just a negative x squared over 2, then 1, 2, then just a n factorial. So when n is 0, so 0 factorial is 1, so here power 0 is 1, so that will be the first term. Okay, so now we're going to use the Taylor series expansion. So here's the Taylor series expansion. Then e to the power t just equals sum n from 0 to infinity, then t to the power n, then n factorial. So now for our case, this is a t. So then equals e to the power t. So then here just equals x times e to the power negative here x squared over 2. So this is simplified expression for the first part of the product. So let's put the label here. That's 1 for the first part. So now let's simplify the second part of the product. Okay, so this is the second part. So let's simplify it. So here we try to figure out what's the general term. Okay, so let's see. So 1 plus, so here, x squared, we put as 2 times 1. Bottom, 2 squared, we put 2 times 1. Okay, so let's see the second term. Second term, x to the fourth, we put 2 times 2. Then take out 2 squared from each term. So then we have 2 squared times 2. Then we still have 1 squared times 2 squared, so we have 2 factorial squared. So then here we are going to put a 1 factorial squared. Okay, so now let's see the next one. X is 6. Put x to the power 2 times 3. Take out 2 squared from each term. So then we have 2 to the power 2 times 3. Then we still have 1 squared times 2 squared times 3 squared. So that's 3 factorial squared. Then keep going. So now we can put them into summing notation. So here, infinity. So the bottom, so let's see the top. X to the power 2 times n. The bottom here, that's a 2 to the power 2n. Then here, just n factorial squared. Okay, so here is n. Okay, so then this is n factorial. So when n is 0, so then here this one is 1, so this one is 1, here's 1, that would be the first term. So this is a simplified expression for the second part. So now we're going to put the 2 simplified expressions into the integral. Okay, so then I for the original question for the integral. So then here from 0 to infinity. So here's the simplified expression for the first part of the product. Okay, so this is for the first part of the product. So now let's put the second part. So here just from 0 to infinity. And here 2 to the power 2n, then here n factorial squared, then dx. Okay, so next step, we're going to switch the sum with the integral. Then here, the sum. Then here we have a 2 to the power 2n. So we're going to take a 1, 2 to the power n out. Leave another 1 inside. So then here, n factorial squared. Then do the integral. Then we're going to write this one first. X to the power 2n. Then here, we still have 1, 2 to the power n. So 2 to the power n, 2 to the power n, that's 2 to the power 2n. So now let's write this term. Then e this part. Then write x. Then dx. So next step, we are going to rewrite the inside integral. Because we try to do a substitution. Okay, so let's see here. Because here we have x squared over 2, so then we try to combine these two together. So that's x squared over 2, then to the power n, then write this term. Then we combine these two together. So we have then dx squared over 2. So now you can tell we can do the substitution. So we use the t for the substitution equals x squared over 2. So for the new variable, we still have the same lower bound, upper bound. So now let's do the substitution. And here, just copy this part. Then do the substitution. Still have the same lower bound, upper bound. So then this is t to the power n. This e to the power negative t. This one dt. So then we need to figure out what's this integral. So maybe you already recognize this integral. So there is a name for it. So that is a gamma of n plus 1. Okay, so this integral just a gamma of n plus 1. So then we need to use the important property above gamma function. So gamma function, when n is a positive integer, gamma of n plus 1 just equals n factorial. So now see, so this n factorial can cancel out 1 n factorial from the bottom. Here's 1. Okay, so then next step, we are going to rewrite this term, put it on top. So now we have here, we're going to put as n from 0 to infinity. So then the bottom, just n factorial. So on top, that's 1/2 to the power n. So then we're going to use Taylor series expansion again. E to the power t, then just equals t to the power n, then n factorial. So this is the second time we use it in this solution. Okay, so then for our case, this is a t. So that's why it just equals e to the power t. Then just equals e to the power 1/2. So just equals square root of e. So that's why square root e is a solution for this question. Thanks for watching. See you next time.